Hello, creative designers, and welcome on today's story. My name is Peter. Head on today's story. We're just going to see how we can be able to beef up our security and protect our website from brutal attacks. We're just going to use a free plugin for the purpose of today's story. What we're just going to see is that whenever you just want to log into a WordPress website, all you just need to do is add a wp-admin, and with that we'll be directed to the login page. What about this? Whenever you just try to log in and if using the wp-admin, you'll be directed to this page. So for instance, let me try to use this one. Whenever I use wp-admin, I just been directed to the home. You can just direct it to any page you wish, maybe in a 404 error page. But what if you just change that wp-admin to something like maybe something new login here? And once you just log in, you'll be just directed. Let me use that one. You'll be directed to this page, and with that, you have just changed this URL to my dashboard. You can customize this link and add more features. In today's story, we're just going to see so many other features that we can be able to do for you to just add more security to your website. We're just going to use for free plugin for the purpose of this tutorial. And without further ado, let's just get into action and I'll show you how. So the first thing we just need to do, we need to get to the dashboard, and on the dashboard menu, scroll now to where we have the plugin, and on how far we have these three options. Yeah, on the plugin repository here, now we have the search, we have not searched the plugin, and it's called Hide My WP. Just type Hide WP. There's so many plugins available here, but the one you're just going to use is from the WP plugins, is WordPress security plugin. You see the WordPress security plugin, and all you just need to do, we install the plugin. You can see it has more than 100,000 active installation. The plugin is from WP plugins, WordPress security plugins. After successful installation, all we just need to do is we activate. For now, the website that we are having, or we have to use WP admin for us to be able to access our dashboard or the login menu. When you just come in here and I just paste here, now you have been directed to the WordPress page. Now we have, after using the wp-admin, we have been directed to this WP login page here. These are the most commonly used logins, credentials, logins links used by WordPress website. So what you just need to do, we need to change this, and whenever you just log in, you just be directed to the dashboard. So we need to change this. First thing we just need to do is now we go to the Hide My WP Ghost. You find it on the dashboard menu here. On click on it, you'll be directed to this page here. And for the first thing we just need to do, we need to activate. To get a free token, so you just need to add your email there and you just click activate. Then for now, our website is on default, and see it's unsafe, so we just need to set it on light mode, and we just need to save here. Let me just open on a new page so that we can see some features that are here. So with you activating, there's some link that have changed automatically. Like for instance, we used to have instead of using wp-admin, now we are going to use new login. So we just go back here and we select on a incognito window, and we say Etsy shop, like here. And once the let me just add here -wp-admin, you see it has not changed, has just directed us to our homepage. But what if we just change now to new login like that? They're just being directed to the homepage. Now from there, we just need to customize some few things in here and there. You can just check it from here, and on click on here, you see if it is working. Yeah, you see it is working, this new link here. So from there, we just need to change some few things. Whenever you just log into the dashboard, like for instance here, you have this WP as your dashboard link. So we need to change that, and you say my dashboard, or you can change it to something that is so unique for you that whenever someone log into the dashboard, they know they are on the dashboard, and you can just hide the new admin path here. So from there, we have now the new login. You can change it here and you say user login like that. And you can maybe use a hyphen login. And once you do that, there are so many other features you can change for the lost password. You can say maybe password recovery. For the password, you can say maybe for the new user, you can change this to register or new user or new registration. For the login path, you can change this link also here. So first of all, let's first of all change here. So save the changes here. So the first thing you just need to do to understand, we had new login, and now we have changed it to user hyphen login. So let's try to use the user login. We just try to use the one we had for new logins. You see, we have been directed to this error page. So let's change now to this user hyphen login like that. You see, we have now been directed here. So let's log in and see where are we going to be if this link here gonna change here. And you see now it has directed us to my dashboard. You can customize that link. It will just help you many other things. So here you can change this one, maybe a good, maybe forgot password, lost pass, or maybe pass recovery. And for this here, you can say user registration, new user. You can customize that, and the login path you can change to something else. So from there, now we have this one here. You need to hide the admin URL. Just hide this one, and instead of showing my dashboard, it will show maybe admin.ajax, but you can also maybe leave it at my dashboard. So from there, just change this one. This is for the custom. You can change the custom WP content path. You can change this link to something that you can maybe they have suggested this one here. You can change it here. And for the library, you can change something like maybe gallery, my library, or whatever it is, maybe for the upload, for the image, you can change, customize all this one here. Then from that, there's this normal link that is always used for the plugin. When someone wants to access and know which plugins you're using, just change it to something, maybe my plugins, or maybe plugin in use or not that. For theme path, just change this link here. And from there, you can disable REST API for the logged out users. One must log in for them to access the REST API. So from there, this one for security setting here, you need pro version for that. And from there, now we have the category path. Whenever someone go to the category, let me just try to find the categories here. Let me select categories here. Whenever someone maybe want to know which category, you can change this one here. Category, we have this one category here. We have this one category here. You can customize and add something, maybe cat or directory in that. For the tag, you can use topic, keyword, my topics, my keywords, and all that. You can customize. After that, remember to save. Here now you can change some few things here and there. Whenever someone is logging, which page are they going to be redirected? And whenever they just log out, which page they will be directed. You can also customize on user roles. You can set for admin and say whenever someone uses the credentials for admins, which page are they going to be directed? So from here, you just need to say, for instance, whenever just someone like customer login, they'll be directed to my account. Let me just be sure and I select the page that I'm just going to redirect them. We have now my account here. Let me just click here and I view it in a new tab. So I just copy this one here, only this, and I copy like that and come here and I paste it like that. And whenever they just log out, I want them to be directed to home. like that. And from there, I just save the changes. So from there, you just come back here and you said either for the admin, which page do you want them to be directed to? And after they log out, which page do you want them to be directed to? You can just set for them here, all of them. If you don't want them to be directed to a certain page and just them to be directed to the dashboard, just leave them as blank. Then from there, you just need to just change this one and toggle this one for the sitemap and for the robot TXT. So you just change path for robot TXT. And from there, you can hide for emoji. You can disable all this one. This one will help you in brute attack forces. And from there, brute force attack. So I just save the changes. So from there, now we go now to the brute force. You're just going to limit some few things here and there. You can see all those blacklisted IP and all that. This plugin will just help you print that. So for the plugin to be, for the IP to be maybe blacklisted sometime, they have to just make some trial or attempt to just log in. So you just say, if someone tried to log in 3 times, they will be banned to use the login link for these seconds. If you divide by this by 65, maybe it's 1 hour. And this is the message they are going to get. Your IP has been flagged for potential security violation. Please try again after. So you can say your IP has been flagged for, and you say please contact admin. You can customize this text from there. And for you to be able to blacklist, to add maybe an IP for you, and for you to be able to add an IP to a whitelist, this IP cannot be blacklisted. You need to have a pro version for that. But for this free version, it worked for me very well. So the other thing is you'll be able to see all those blacklisted IP, and you can be able to remove them on your end as admin. So from there, now we have now the math check protection. You can have them here. Now whenever you just try to log in, let's just get back here and I show you. Now when you just now try to log in, now we have this math here. It must be solved for you to be able to log in. It will just help us now to limit the brute force attack on our website. So from there, there's so many other features that they have that you can be able to check. For this, you need a pro version. Then from there, they have the plugin that they have suggested that works very correctly with Hide by WP. You can check them here. If maybe you're planning to maybe when you just have some conflict with some of other plugins working with this plugin, they have suggested those plugins you can work with. But for me, I have worked, they haven't given me any errors. So I have worked it very well. It has worked for me. The other thing is you can back up the setting and you can upload the setting on other website. What you just need to do is just back up, and whenever you just want to reinstall, just click here and upload the setting. And from there, now we have the advanced. So from there, now you can, they have just added some few new logins here. So they have just, you have to change something. Like for this link, I'm just going to use this one. This is the link that whenever you just have whenever you just get an error, you cannot be able to access your website. You need to have this link. So you just have to copy this link and put it on safe side. Whenever you just, maybe you find that your IP has been locked out and you just want to access your website instantly, just use this link. You just need to copy it and paste it somewhere. Another thing, you just optimize the CSS and JS file, prevent slow loading for the website. Load must use plugin. Let's load in and clean login page that, and you just save the changes. In case of any error, just update your email from this end and remember to save. So from there, I don't think there's so many other features that you can be able to check, but if you find that it's not working for you, you can consider maybe upgrading to a pro version and see all that feature. That if I get the pro version, I'll come up and do the tutorial for the for you guys. Even you here, consider subscribing. I hope you did learn something out of this tutorial. See you next time. Thank you.